Hi friends, welcome back to my channel SciTeker. In this video, I'm going to do the speed test comparison between the Realme GT2 device versus Realme XL Max device. And this video is going to be slightly kind of different. The main reason is because the Realme XL Max, which I'm trying to use, is a 12GB RAM version. Exactly, yes. So this is a video which a lot of viewers are actually interested in. The main reason is because, so whenever you try to buy the Realme smartphones, always prefer 12GB RAM versions. So it is a clear proof what's going on. I'll try to explain you why I did ask you to prefer the 12GB RAM versions as well. And these are the 9 applications, and these are the only one Battlegrounds mobile game which I'm going to test the RAM management thing and the speed test also. So let me do quickly reboot the both phones first, and let's restart the both phones, and we'll try to see exactly what's going on as well between these two devices. So there's nothing to do with the Realme UI 2.0 and 3.0. Yes, 3.0, I did not see much kind of like increase or decrease in RAM management. It was like exactly similar. Maybe in the previous version of 2.0, slightly kind of maybe better, but that's not huge difference. I did not notice. But the huge difference will be there from 8GB to 12GB. Trust me guys, so 12GB RAM, in case if you're having sufficient budget, prefer the 12GB RAM models in the Realme smartphones. Not in the iQOO and Mi phones, no problem. Go for the 6GB and 8GB, no problem. No issues with the RAM management, but especially in the Realme smartphones, in the ColorOS, not only in Realme, in the ColorOS, always prefer the highest RAM variant as possible to give you the better results. Right now, both phones are connected to same exactly 2.4GHz Wi-Fi network as well, both phones. And I did enable external RAM capabilities 8 plus 5GB in the Realme GT2, which is of no use at all, but still I'm trying to show you because you should know, right? So now let's start the speed test comparison between these both phones and then RAM management test. So this is going to be really very interesting. So try to observe the difference, what's happening with the 12GB and the 8GB. So how much powerful it can be there. Yes, I do know the price is slightly kind of expensive for the 12GB RAM models, but if you plan to use for the next 2 to 3 years, like why not like spend some money extra and be happy with that. That's what my opinion is exactly, friends. So let's go to the mobiles. In the mobiles, we'll try to select one random phone. Let's select this phone and keep it in the background RAM management as well. So it's a Flipkart application, and right now let's open some random phone. Keep this Samsung phone in the background. It's a speed test. In the speed test, we'll try to keep the speed test results as a background. In every application, I'm trying to keep something as a background, right? That's the reason I'm trying to show you exactly. And let's open the Battlegrounds mobile game as well. Put in this both phones exactly right now. So don't worry about this game space getting activated, because even if the game space is getting activated, still the RAM management going to be good in the 12GB RAM models especially. I think I forgot to clear this game from the game space. So let's see. So Dimensity 1200 and the Snapdragon 888 processor, so which is having right now. And next is a daily and application. Let's open this and keep in the background is Oddster, and let's scroll down to the end of the menu and we'll try to keep this in the background. Yes. Prime videos. So it's a YouTube application. I'm trying to keep my YouTube page as a background in the RAM management. Now all the 9 applications and one game is completely open, right, in the RAM management, as you can clearly see. Now try to observe the difference, like 12GB RAM version versus 8GB RAM. You will definitely notice the difference regarding the RAM management thing. So this is a kind of really important for a lot of other users. Let's start with the first application, which is the Chrome application. Let's see, 1, 2 and 3, boom. It did not even get reloaded in the 12GB RAM version. So yes, there is difference with the RAM management in the 12GB RAM versus 8GB. So it's a clear proof what's going on. It's there in the background RAM management. Like if a phone is functioning like this in the beginning, then definitely after even 2 years also, like no need to rely on the software updates to fix these small issues. You can see it's there in the background. Like most of the applications are getting reloaded. I'm not sure whether you are observing from the multitasking, and when I try to open the game, whether they are there or not in Daliant. So it's got reloaded, it's there exactly. Hotstar again got reloaded, but it's there in the bottom menu now, right now. You can see, friends, clearly what's going on. Prime Videos is there. YouTube, my page is there. It's not there. So, friends, clearly, yeah, it's not there. Yeah. So clearly, it shows that 12GB RAM is the best option to buy in the Realme smartphone. So that's what I thought of concluding in this video exactly. So it doesn't matter what Realme you buy, 2.0 or 3.0. It doesn't matter in the Realme phones, not much effect. But 8GB and 12GB, that will be impacting a lot of RAM management. So which gives you the really good feel as well. No applications will be closing in the background most of the time. Even if you open 30 applications also, this 12GB RAM can keep 30. Yes, so please think about it. In case if you have the budget, then go for it. Otherwise, no problem. You can go for the 8GB RAM, and maybe with the future updates, they might improve. But which I cannot guarantee that. Meanwhile, signing off, friends. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more updates. I'll definitely do the 8GB RAM comparison as well with the Realme XN Max. So stay tuned for those videos in case if you're interested. Meanwhile, signing off. Until next time, stay tuned for more updates and bye.